Wow, Batista coming under Raw. That's not going to make the folks on SmackDown very happy. He's a great athlete. He's sticking to great athletes. Here comes the heavyweight champion of the world.
He's not very happy either. A blindfold match for the world champion.
Now less than 2 weeks from this champion versus champion winner take all match against Kane in Little Rock, Arkansas. No mercy on pay-per-view.
Wonder what kind of match I'm going to be if you don't think that Eric Bischoff would stick me in that tennis match chair match with Kane, do you? I do know that man right there said earlier that after tonight, Kane's life would never be the same.
Now, what do you mean by that?
I don't know.
Life will never be the same after tonight.
Well, let me just tell you that Subway presents WWE No Mercy. No Mercy comes to you live in just 13 days, Sunday, October 20th, from the All-Tel Arena in Little Rock, Arkansas, exclusively on pay-per-view. Fresh-made sandwiches on fresh-baked bread. Subway, eat fresh.
I know there's only been one other blindfold match I can recall in WWE history. I think it was around WrestleMania 7, Jake the Snake and Rick Martel.
And making his way to the ring, Chicago, Illinois.
D'Lo Brown makes his way to the ring to compete in this blindfold match on titles. We're going to be in Phoenix, Arizona tomorrow night. I must remind you of that. Great fans in Arizona will be converging on Phoenix tomorrow night at the America West Arena. We look forward to seeing you there.
Yeah, might as well go there. The Diamondbacks are done, aren't they?
They're more than done, unfortunately for them.
Phoenix is a great city, but it ain't got nothing on Las Vegas. We got sex, we got sin, we got lust, greed, and danger right here tonight. We got Raw Roulette, JR.
These Americans are ready to be blindfolded in this blindfold match. They'll have to be blindfolded through the entire match. The match can end with pinfalls or submission, we are told.
These aren't just those little blindfolds like you like to play with at night, JR. These are big, heavy black sacks you got to put over you. He can't see a thing with this on.
And I wonder what Flair meant for telling Bischoff, before you select Triple H's opponent, bribing those girls is as bad as New Jersey politics. I mean, well, here they are. Now, this has got to be a first for a lot of folks. I haven't seen a match of this type in, my God, for years. And you're in a blindfold, you can't see.
Behind you! Turn around, Triple H!
Look at Claire ringside.
Instructions. This is where Flair can really be valuable right here.
They're trying to direct some traffic there.
Well, no, there. Well, no, there.
D'Lo Brown ain't no pushover. I guarantee you that.
Somebody's probably telling Flair what Flair is not allowed to tell Triple H where D'Lo is. What's wrong with that? Look at there he is. There he is.
And there they lock up. That's, I remember in Oklahoma, they had the Oklahoma Scoop of one at a heck of a wrestling team. An amateur team, that is. And
wait. Triple H is talking smack. D'Lo ain't even there.
Well, I'll tell you what, Triple H was not happy about this, considering we're less than 2 weeks away from No Mercy. Champion versus champion.
You got it, a lucky shot.
Winner take all, Triple H and Kane.
Get it.
Oh, look out.
Hit him.
Referee is saying it's Earl. It's a right hand. Triple H and well, what a... And how do you?
You gotta feel with your feet, you gotta feel with your hands, and if you feel something, hit it. Kick it. There you go.
This is not, you wouldn't want to be wearing any strong cologne.
Yeah, I was gonna talk to you about that. What are you wearing? Oh, that's on the skunk.
Oh, Triple H. He knows where he is right now. Triple H.
He got him.
Trying to hook up.
He got him. Oh,
D'Lo Brown, that pedigree, and D'Lo, that broke his way out of it. And now D'Lo was trained by a field in this blindfold match. And look at this, a hook to the leg. And D'Lo looking for an upset here.
Yeah, now he's lost again.
I saw the late Dick Murdoch and Killer Carl Cox in one of these matches. It had to be 20 years ago. Oh, D-Lo. D-Lo, that could do it. The sky high there for D-Lo. That big power bomb of his.
And Flair.
Triple H rolling until he felt the ropes, and now Flair's telling Triple H something. Well, these two form an unholy alliance.
There's the back. Look at Flair. There's how valuable he is.
Hey, wait a minute. Triple H has got that hood off. Flair's got the referee distracted. Triple H is cheating.
No.
Triple H is. Well, that's sure as hell not fair. Triple H with Flair distracted the referee.
What a victory! What a win for the world champion! That shows you how valuable Ric Flair can be at ringside.
I'm still wondering though what Triple H meant when he said referring to Kane before this night is over. Triple H promises that Kane's life will never be the same.
Well, I just tell you this, Triple H doesn't ever make any promises that he doesn't keep. If I were Kane, I'd be watching my back.